So unfortunately, this speech has no message. And even if it did, half of you aren't in the proper state to remember it. I'd especially like to thank all the family members who traveled here from near and far today to watch our principal butcher the graduates' day. That line may hurt a little, but at least we can joke about it. Kind of like the fact that we are still in school 2 weeks after every other senior in Kansas City had already graduated. I'd like to point out that the one-to-one learning initiative has really done some good things for the school district. Thanks to the laptops, we've been able to watch countless Fortnite streams while studying. I'd also like to extend a special thank you to all my teachers who taught me these last 4 years. We've been privileged to learn from some of the best teachers in the world. They are truly some of the most kind-hearted and giving people, and they make tons of sacrifices for us. For example, they have drowned themselves in student loan debt their entire lives to give us the wonderful opportunity to also drown in student loan debt their entire lives. During my time at Park Hill, I have had the privilege of learning from many great teachers, including taking 4 years of French class taught by the best French teacher in the state of Missouri, and in my humble opinion, the entire nation. Madame not only excelled at teaching us about French language and culture, but also about life. The best example of this was our end of the year assignment to read Le Petit Prince, or The Little Prince, by Antoine de Saint-Exupéry. The Little Prince is the fourth best-selling book in the entire world, with 140 million copies sold since its original publication in 1943. So we can all assume, without even reading it, that it has some important life lessons and wisdom that everybody can benefit from. This book also has special significance for me. It was the first gift that my grandfather ever gave to my grandmother, so obviously when reading it, I took his message to heart. On one of the Little Prince's adventures, he travels to a planet where he meets a businessman. His entire life is dedicated to collecting and counting his stars. When the Little Prince tries to talk to him, he keeps repeating the phrase, "Je suis sérieux, moi. I am serious, mate." The businessman was completely out of touch with the rest of the universe and would never find happiness because he was so serious and never took the time to enjoy life. I encourage all of you to never become like a businessman. Whatever life throws at you, you can get through. No matter the hardships that you encounter, always remember that you are in control of your happiness, and that is more important than anything else in the world. So stay positive, crack jokes, and never take yourselves too seriously. The great Andy Bernard once said, "I wish there was a way to know you in the good old days before you actually left them." Well, Trojans, your good old days are now. Go out and live them to the fullest. Take risks, have fun, and be happy. Because in 20 years, when you're driving a screaming kids to school in your Honda Odyssey, you don't want to look back on this time and think of how good it could have been. I hope you remember these days fondly and live them without any regrets. Now, before I get off the stage and end this enormous power trip I'm currently on, I'd like to share a quote from one of my favorite teachers at Park Hill. He's a man that we all know and love for his quirkiness and complete inability to filter anything he says. Mr. Victor L. Lobo Abundance. Mr. Abundance always seems to have the key to happiness. And this week he told my composition and reading class something I felt summed up the spirit of graduation like itself, really. He told us, "Guys, seriously, the most important thing to remember to do when you wake up in the morning is to do whatever it is that makes you happy." So Park Hill, class of 2018, hope each and every one of you, when you wake up in the morning, never forgets to do what makes you happy. Because the most important decisions we can ever make are the ones that make you and those around you happy. Thank you all, and happy graduation. We love you.